When we come to artificial intelligence and the possibility of their becoming conscious, we reach a profound philosophical difficulty. I am a philosophical naturalist. I am committed to the view that there is nothing in our brains that violates the laws of physics. There's nothing that could not, in principle, be reproduced in technology. It hasn't been done yet. We're probably quite a long way away from it. But I see no reason why in future we shouldn't reach the point where a human-made robot is capable of consciousness and of feeling pain. We can feel pain, why shouldn't they? And this is profoundly disturbing because it kind of goes against the grain to think that a machine made of metal and silicon chips could feel pain, but I don't see why they would not. And so that this moral consideration of how to treat artificially intelligent robots will arise in the future, and it's a problem which philosophers and moral philosophers are already talking about. Once again, I'm committed to the view that this is possible. I'm committed to the view that anything that a human brain can do can be replicated in silicon. And so I'm sympathetic to the misgivings that have been expressed by highly respected figures like Elon Musk and Stephen Hawking, that we ought to be worried, that on the precautionary principle we should worry about a takeover, perhaps even, by robots, by our own creation, especially if they reproduce themselves and potentially even evolve by reproduction and don't need us anymore. This is a science fiction speculation at the moment, but I think philosophically I'm committed to the view that it is possible. And like any major advance, we need to apply the precautionary principle and ask ourselves what the consequences might be. It could be said that the sum of not human happiness, but the sum of sentient being happiness might be improved. They might make a better job, do a better job of running the world than we are, certainly than we are at present. And so perhaps it might be no bad thing if we went extinct. And our civilization, the memory of Shakespeare and Beethoven and Michelangelo persisted in silico rather than in brains and our form of life. And one could foresee a future time when silicon beings look back on a dawn age when the earth was peopled by soft, squishy, watery, organic beings. And who knows, that might be better, but we're really in science fiction territory now.